Hello friends, welcome to our channel Mechanical Motivator. In this video, we are going to see an introduction to cycloid and how to draw cycloid curve. So a cycloid is a curve generated by a point P on the circumference of the circle which moves along the straight line without slipping. Application of cycloid or example of cycloid for clear understanding, we can go for a two-wheeler front wheel rotating for a one complete revolution on a straight road, or else try to just rotate or spin, no, don't need to spin, just rotate a coin on a horizontal table. It will be rotating for a 360 degree, one complete revolution without slipping. So these are the example for cycloid. So cycloid, the key term is without slipping. Just see here, this is the directing line and this is the rolling circle. This circle starting point is here. Now when the circle rotate, it will be tracing a curve. See, listen here, when the circle try to rotate, automatically this point will be traced as a curve. So here, see, listen here. So this curve only we're going to trace it up. And this is the circumference of the circle. And this is for one complete revolution, 360 degree. We will be getting a curve like this. And this curve is called as a cycloidal curve. So now we'll go to question. A coin of 40 mm diameter. So diameter of the circle is 40 mm. Rolls over a horizontal table. So this is the hint. Without slipping. So without slipping means it's a cycloid. A point on the circumference of the coin is in contact with the table surface in the beginning and after one complete revolution. One complete revolution is 360 degree. Draw the path traced by a point and also draw a tangent and normal at any point on the curve. So this we'll deal at the end of the, after getting the curve, we'll deal with. So first surface, you need to draw a circle, and circle will be having a diameter 40 mm. So radius will be 20 mm. Take a radius of 20 mm, that is 2 cm, and with your compass and try to draw a circle. First step. The second step is we need to divide the circle in 12 equal parts. So 360 degree divided by 12 means we'll be getting 30 degree. So you can place your protractor here and you can divide as 30, 60, 90, 150, 180, 180 likewise. And also you can tilt the protractor upside down. You can divide with same manner, 30, 60, 90 likewise. If this is the one procedure, and another procedure also is there. So this is a circle, right? Take a radius of 20 mm. This is the radius of the circle. Take a radius of 20 mm. Keep your compass here. Try to cut an arc to your left and right. Keep your compass here. Try to cut an arc with a radius of 20 mm to your left and right. Now keep your compass here. Try to cut an arc to your left and right. Last, keep your compass here. Try to cut an arc towards your left and right. After that, you will be having some arcs, right? So these arcs are nothing but division of the circle into 12 equal parts. You can follow any one of the procedure, whichever is convenient for you. After dividing it, we know very well that circumference of the circle is pi d. So d is 40. So pi into 40, we will be having 125.67 millimeter. So this line is the circumference of the circle, and the length of this line is given as 125.67. So just draw this line. And then try to draw this line, same, this is also for the same distance, and try to close this box. This is your next step. No need to write the dimension now. After completing diagram, we can write all the dimensions. The next step is we need to divide that circumference line, right? We need to divide this circumference line into 12 equal parts. For that, what we're going to do? Just draw an inclined line with 30 degree, and then divide this line as I said in previous video. Take a distance of 1 cm in your compass. Keep your compass at here. Try to cut an arc. Likewise, keep your compass here. Try to cut an arc for 1 cm. Likewise, try to divide this line for 12 equal parts. And then you will be getting these arcs. Connect the last arc with the edge of this diagram. Connect this arc to the edge of this diagram. So you will be connecting like this, and previous arc to the circumference line. So these lines should be parallel. These lines should be parallel. After drawing it, try to rub these portion, these and all, or unnecessary portion, we can rub it up because it will be very much a disturbance during dimensioning. So after the, now you have divided the circumference line into 12 equal parts, you will be getting a points like this. and try to write as 1-2-3-, because already we have written the 1-2-3 for the numbering for the circle, and the numbering should be in anti-clockwise. The reason is this: when the circle rotates, when the circle rolls, this one will be merging with the 1-, this two will be merging with the 2-, that is the meaning for that. After complete revolution of one revolution, the entire 12th point will be coming to the 12-. So just rub the remaining portion, whatever you drawn at the bottom. The next step is this circle is called as a generating circle, and this line is called as a directing line. Now try to draw the parallel lines. Take your scale. You have to connect 7, 5. Both should be same. I have drawn this diagram in pain. These diagrams are drawn without any dimension, so it's just here. Try to understand the concept and procedure. When you draw with the exact dimension, you will be getting whatever you get will be the correct answer. 7 and 5 will be on the same line. So just connect 7 and 5 and try to extend this line till the end of this. Likewise, 8 and 4 extend. 9, 3, the center of the circle, all will be in the same line. Try to extend it. Likewise, you extend all the lines. Then you have already got that point here, right? 1-2-. Try to extend that line vertically to the locus of center. So this is the center of the circle, and this line is called as the locus of center. Try to extend that line vertically and name that point as C1, C2, C3, C4, C5, so on till C12. The next step is, now take your compass. Now you have to take a radius of 20 mm. The reason is the radius of the circle is 20 mm. So whatever the radius of the circle, take that radius 20 mm in your compass. Now keep your compass at the center, C1 as your center. Cut an arc to the corresponding line. If it's C1 means cut first line. If it's C2 means cut the second line. If it's C3 means cut the corresponding third line. Likewise, if C4 means cut the corresponding fourth line. So likewise, you cut till C6. After that, what happens when you are cutting for C7? The curve we should get a curve like this only, right? So when you are keeping your compass at C7, you will be cutting an arc at here, seventh line. You can also cut an arc at the left also, but after 6, try to follow the right side. Till 6, you will be cutting an arc towards your left, and after 6, you will be cutting an arc towards your right side of the portion. After you cut means you will be getting an arc like this till C12. Okay, do in a similar manner, and after that try to join all the curves, join all the arcs. Try to join all the arcs. You will be getting a curve like this, and your arc which you cut will be likely outside of the curve. Try to rub all those things because it will be untidy, right? Try to rub all the arc which is outside the curve, so that a curve should be very smooth. The curve should be drawn with HB pencil. Next, draw tangent and normal at any point on the curve. So at any point on the curve, just try to mark a point P. Okay, mark point P. Then with P as center, take 20 mm radius. With P as marking this point, we can mark anywhere. I have marked this point P on this point. With 20 mm as center, keep your compass at P. Try to cut an arc at the locus of center. This is the locus of center. Cut an arc at the locus of center. With P as center, 20 mm as radius, cut an arc. Now try to join this arc. You have got one point, right? Try to bring this point vertically downwards. Draw a line. Draw a line vertically downwards till it touches the circumference of the circle. Then here we will be getting one point, right? Here we will be getting one point. Just connect this point and the point which you kept on the curve. Once again, I repeat, with 20 mm as radius, P as center, try to cut an arc. You will be cutting an arc at the locus of center. Here you will be having one point. Try to bring that point vertically downwards. It will be touching the circumference circle. Now join this point with the point which you kept on the curve. So you will be getting the normal. N'N' will be your normal. And now you have to draw tangent. N'N' as normal. P as center, draw a 90 degree perpendicular line like this. That line will be touching the curve only at one point, and that line is called as a tangent. Once again, I repeat, N'N' as center, N'N' as base, P as center. With the help of your protractor, draw a 90 degree line. It's a perpendicular line, and that line will be touching the curve at one point, and that is T'T', which is nothing but tangent. Only your curve, tangent, and normal should be dark. It should be drawn with HB pencil. After drawing it, after completing it, now we can dimension. Go for dimension. This is the dimension line. This is the extension line. These lines should be very, very light, and the value should be vertically. And you have to break the line and write like this. The arrowhead should be 3:1 ratio, sharp pointed one. And diameter, we can represent the diameter like this. This line is called as a leader line. You can represent diameter in terms of 540. So dimension line should be, dimension and extension line should be very light. Dimension line should be drawn with H pencil, and extension line should be drawn with 2H pencil. The extension line should be one mm away from the diagram. And after completing it, you will be in your A3 sheet. You have to write the heading. Heading is cycloid. Height of the text is 10 mm. These are the subheadings. The height of the text is 7 mm. All dimensions are in mm, and scale 1:1 should be 5 mm. So once you complete your diagram, try to represent as neat as possible. Then only you will be grabbing the marks. In case if you have any doubt, means you just type in the comment section. I will be clarifying all your doubts. After completing, your diagram should be like this. This is just an example. Once you complete your diagram, means you will be getting a cycloid like this.